Dear students, let us start the discussion on 22nd March 2016 newspaper. The first article is related to the Honor Killings and it is by Brinda Karat. Now, in India, the caste factor, class factor, control over the women, all these three together decreasing the choice necessary for the young people to choose their partners. And it is taking the form of the honor killings who have broken the norms of the society. And these norms of the society are taken forward or implemented by the cup panchayats. And these cup panchayats are also certain other retrogressive institutions. So they are taking the law into their hand. So in this context, this violation of the law has to be solved and justice has to be delivered to these people. So in this context, first we shall acknowledge that there is a problem in India. On the other hand, India feels about its record on human rights that is going to be violated if India moves towards or recognizes the existence of the honor killings on its land. So that's why whenever the discussion comes up in United Nations or in the parliament, the governments are not ready to acknowledge the problem. And the second is, after the problem is acknowledged, an effective law has to be made. So the law, it shall give a legal protection because it is the constitutional responsibility. So the state has to protect the rights of the people which are constitutionally guaranteed. So and next, the protection again is the misuse also shall be the part of the law. Now, if you see anti-dowry acts, many of these laws which are supposed to provide for the protection to the women are used or misused for the advantage. So in this context, certain safeguards also have to be provided for. The conclusion can be seized. India needs a strong law so that will protect all the citizens and their choices. And these choices are the democratic rights of the people in this country. And the next is Saudi Arabia. Coming to Saudi Arabia, it is going through a very critical phase now. One, there is fall in oil prices, and that is commodity prices. Next, diplomatically, Iran is emerging as a favorite destination for many countries, which was the arch enemy of the Saudi Arabia. The United States, which was actually the friend of Saudi Arabia, it has got close engagement with the other countries in the region. The passage of the Iran nuclear deal, China moving close to the Iran, these are not in good spirits of the Saudi Arabia. And on the other hand, Pakistan has disagreed to participate in air bombing at Yemen, which was led by the Saudi Arabia. So in this context, now India has a strategic advantage to move into the Saudi Arabia. So or else to gain its relationship with the Saudi Arabia. Already India made the strategic partnership in 2010 and also defense partnership in 2014. So taking this to the next level, the Saudi Arabia is now looking for connectivity and also it is looking for alternative chances of making the economy to grow. So this provides for the new opportunities and the Prime Minister's coming visit to Saudi Arabia has to take this into cognizance. And coming to the Commonwealth, what are its achievements? Now, Commonwealth was originally a cultural organization or an organization based on the common values among the previous colonies ruled by the Queen. So in this context, during the Kamlesh Sharma's reign as secretary to the Commonwealth, what are the decisions taken? The first one is debt swap agreement to decrease the vulnerabilities and risks of the different members of the Commonwealth has been finalized. And then climate action or climate change also has become the important agenda of the Commonwealth. And after that, a 16-point charter is being developed and members are expected to follow the 16-point charter, which consists of free media, your freedoms, independent voice, all these things as part of that. And next is, multilateral agencies are also started observing what the Commonwealth is doing, especially its concept of resilience and vulnerability of the economy, how it has to be faced. It has got the great attention from across the world. And the important initiative with the use of ICT, it is Commonwealth Connects. It means it has developed an information communication technology framework that brings the round the clock, round the world, a continuous connectivity between the members of the Commonwealth. Finally, the citizen has made central to the Commonwealth initiatives now, either it is in the fields of the climate change, youth, development, electoral oversight, everywhere, the citizens are being taken into confidence and they are made central to the engagement. So these are the developments. Now coming to the Nepal-China relationships. You know that the Prime Minister Oli is visiting China, and in this relationship, the first major challenge is this. The Nepal is expected to be a bridge between India and China. But however, because of the recent incidents that have happened, that is Madhesi agitation, India's support to the Madhesi agitation, and recommendation for an inclusive constitution, all this did not go well with the elite of the Nepal. So because of this, a kind of a blockade has led the Nepal to look for the alternatives. So Nepal has signed a transit agreement which provides for the access to the ports to the ports of the China to the Nepal. So second thing is, though the agreement is signed, to what extent the logistics will allow for this implementation is a major question. Added to that, on the infrastructure front also, there are few agreements or few understandings were reached. So the Nepal was requesting China to extend the Tibetan railway to up to Nepal. And next is, it also is requesting it for development of intra-city railway. So it means a deepening of the relationship which is happening between China and Nepal. So this shows a deepening of the entry of China into the affairs of the South Asia. And coming to the President Obama's visit to the Cuba. So in this visit, now what are the demands of the Cuba? So the Guantanamo Bay, this naval base, has to be closed. And second is, the trade embargo has to be totally lifted. So the trade and transport has to be facilitated. On the other hand, United States of America is looking for a multi-party democracy, of freedoms of the people, free media, and all these things. So in this context, so the human rights record of the Cuba was criticized. So, but however, the Castro, the Raul Castro, he is very critical about the America imposing the democracy, and he wanted it shall be the choice of the people of the Cuba. And added to that, he don't want to relent back with regard to the single party communist system he had. Now coming to Seychelles, the Navy aircraft is on a mission to Seychelles. So with regard to this, the first one is, Indian Navy for the first time has deployed P-81, a reconnaissance aircraft on the Seychelles. So it will look the reconnaissance, it will do the reconnaissance on the exclusive economic zone of the Seychelles. So this increases the maritime interaction between India and the Indian Ocean countries. So added to that, as the competition between India and China is increasing, obviously if India provides for the similar choices, it will be a choice because of the polity, that is, we are a democratic nation, and the geographical proximity. So this have to be understood. So there are no much important articles today. That's why I'm closing it now. Next, let's discuss the yesterday's question. The solution to the problem of Kashmir lies in deepening of engagement. Now with regard to the, if you take the past of the Kashmir, as slowly there is an increase in the participation in elections, and local panchayat bodies were revived, and almost the argument on the Article 370 appears to be settled. The militancy is decreased. But now, as Article 370's discussion is revived, and militancy is also being revived, the insecurity among the Kashmiris is growing. So, the Vajpayee's insaniyat, development, stable democracy, and constructive engagement, and political parties, deepening of the political participation, and democratic giving a due role in the Jammu and Kashmir can be a solution. You can talk about all these points over there. That will become a sufficient answer to your yesterday's question. And try to mention about Article 317, how it is a connection between the Jammu and Kashmir and India. Thank you very much.